Hello beautiful people. In today's video I will tell you why farmed salmon is one of the most poisonous foods ever. Fish has long been praised as superfood by doctors, nutritionists and specialists from all over the world. Many people choose not to eat meat or other animal products and are rather proud of their supposedly health-conscious decision to consume fish. But as with almost everything else, which is heavily advertised in the media, here is something wrong. There is no denying that fish contains many essential omega-3 fatty acids that are known to be good for your brain. Many consider fish brain food because these nutrients are essential to brain health. Unfortunately, farmed fish, especially salmon and perch, cause more harm than good. And with increasing awareness, many experts claim that farmed fish are one of the most toxic foods in the world. What is the problem with fish farms? Today, fisheries face a number of problems, including overfishing, chemical pollution, and even genetic mutations due to toxic effects. Nicholas Daniels' documentary, Filet o' Fish, takes a critical look at the fish farming industry around the world, showing exclusive insider shots of fish farms and how they work. According to the film producer, the meat of the fish we eat has become a deadly chemical cocktail through intensive farming and global pollution. Unfortunately, aquaculture often advertises itself as a sustainable solution against the overfishing of the oceans. However, the reality is that fish farms are actually causing more problems than they are solving. And it seems that it's more important for these companies to make a profit than sustainability or environmental concerns. Farmed salmon is one of the most poisonous foods in the world. The above-mentioned film starts in Norway and documents the chemicals used in fish farms. Kurt Oddekalve, a respected Norwegian environmental activist, is convinced that salmon farming is a disaster for human health and the environment. Among the salmon farms of the Norwegian fjords, there is a 15-meter-high waste layer, which, as you can imagine, is teeming with bacteria, medicines and pesticides. Since these farms are operated in open waters, the entire seabed has been destroyed. And the pollution caused by these farms is not spatially limited. A salmon farm can take up almost 2 million fish in a relatively small space. Due to these overcrowded conditions, diseases among fish are widespread. To ward off disease, various pesticides are used, and if you eat this fish, there is no doubt that you also eat these pesticides yourself. Toxicologist Jerome Rusin confirmed some of Oddekalve's statements after testing toxins on a number of different food groups sold in Norway. He found that farmed salmon contains the largest amount of toxins, and extremely high levels. The farmed salmon was 5 times more toxic than any other food product tested. A study in which farmed salmon were fed to mice showed how the mice became obese, especially with fat around their internal organs, and they also developed diabetes. In recent years, it has been found that diabetes is caused by much more than just sugar, especially those caused by toxic chemicals and air pollutants in the foods we consume. And in this case, we learn that salmon is that way bred, inevitably contain far more toxins than their wild counterparts. As highlighted in the documentation, the most surprising source of toxic exposure to fish is not even pesticides or antibiotics, but the normal dry feed pellets. These contain a whole host of other toxic chemicals, including dioxins and PCBs, and these fish never had a chance. The list of everything that is wrong in the farmed fish industry is getting longer and longer. And if you want to know more about it, you should look at the documentation in the video description. So, what can we do? At all costs, stop eating farmed fish. This is the most effective measure you can take to save your health and prevent that industry from further polluting the oceans and our environment. If you have not decided to stop consuming animal products and are still considering eating fish, you should stick to wild Atlantic salmon, Alaskan salmon, which must not be bred, or start a new hobby and fish your own fish. You can tell the difference between farmed and wild fish by its color. Because farmed fish is usually very pale pink, and wild captive is deep red. Wild salmon can be quite expensive, so sardines and anchovies can be a good alternative for their nutritional value and sustainability level. There are also a number of plant-based alternatives that give your brain what it needs without the risk of toxic contamination. These include walnuts, Brussels sprouts, chia, hemp and flaxseed. Saving a few dollars with cheaper fish is not worth risking your own health. If you're in a restaurant or eating sushi, ask if the fish was bred and where it came from. The only way to stop this industry from moving forward is to stop our support as consumers. And frankly, this industry should be stopped legally. As awareness of this massive issue continues to grow, it is only a matter of time before it is legislated. Thanks for watching today's video. Did you learn anything new today? If you find this video helpful, give me a big thumbs up. Please, don't forget to comment and subscribe for daily videos. Bye and see you in the next video.